Hi friends, welcome to Delicacies on the Plate. Today I am going to make sarso ka saag. Sarso ka saag is easily available during winter season. It is enjoyed with makke ki roti. You can also enjoy it with plain roti, chapati, puri or naan. So let's start making it. To make sarso ka saag, here and I have taken one big bowl of sarso ka saag which I have chopped, and then one bowl of spinach leaves and one bowl of bathua. Now I'm going to add this all the leaves, spinach leaves, mustard leaves and bathua into a pressure cooker with 1 glass of water, salt to taste and 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and pressure cook it up to 3 whistles or till they are nicely cooked. So herein goes the spinach leaves. After the spinach leaves goes in the mustard leaves. And then I'll add the bathua. So after this, I'm going to add in 1 glass of water. Goes in salt to taste and 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. I'll cover the lid and pressure cook it up to 3 whistles. So after all the leaves are cooked, let the pressure cooker cool down and then open the lid. Herein you can see all the leaves have cooked nicely. You can see here the turmeric has not dissolved completely. Doesn't matter, I'm going to mash the saag nicely and I'm going to blend it with the hand blender. I'm not going to blend it into the grinder, otherwise it will become a smooth paste. I don't want to make a smooth paste. Instead, I want the saag to remain half into a bit of chunky form. So now let this saag cool down completely. Meanwhile, I'll start preparing tadka for it. Now in the heated kadai, I'm going to add in 3 to 4 tablespoons of clarified butter. In this, I am going to add in 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds and let it splutter. After the cumin seeds are done, the color changes of the cumin seeds, I am going to add in some whole spices. These whole spices will give a nice flavor to the saag. So I would suggest to add some whole spices. Herein I have 2 red chilies, which are the spicy one. After this, 1 star anise, 2 to 3 sticks of cinnamon, 5 to 6 cloves, 1 big cardamom. I'm going to cook this on a low heat for around 30 to 45 seconds. Then goes in 3 green chilies finely chopped, 1 tablespoon of minced garlic and 1 tablespoon of grated ginger. Cook it till the raw aroma diminishes, and then I'm going to add in 1 big onion which is finely chopped. So this won't take much time. After the ginger and garlic are done, I am going to add in the onions and cook it till it starts to turn golden in color. I am not going to overcook the onion. As soon as the onion turns golden in color, I am going to add in 3 medium size of tomatoes finely chopped, and then I am going to cook till the tomatoes turn tender and it starts to leave the clarified butter. Desi ghee starts to separate. Tomatoes turn tender faster and it is cooked completely. I am going to cover it and cook it on a low heat for about 4 to 5 minutes. Meanwhile, I am going to blend the cooked saag. So herein I'll blend it with the hand blender so that it is not mashed up completely. So herein you can see the saag is ready, which I am going to add it to the kadhai. It's done now. In the kadhai now I am going to add in some dry spices. The tomato is also cooked nicely and the clarified butter has started to separate.
for dry spices, herein I have 1 teaspoon of coriander seeds powder, 3/4 teaspoon of garam masala and 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. Just add it, mix it and cook for around 30 to 45 seconds so that the masalas are cooked nicely. And then I am going to add in the finely chopped green coriander leaves. Green coriander leaves when cooked with this onion and tomato paste will give a nice fresh flavor into the saag. So this is around one small bowl of green coriander leaves. Add it, mix it and let it cook for around a minute. After the coriander leaves are done, I am going to add in the saag paste and mix the saag paste along with the masala completely. Goes in half cup of water as per the consistency. And to this, I am going to add in 2 tablespoons of corn flour. This is makai ka aata what I am adding here. This will give a nice thickness and consistency to the saag. After the makai ka aata is added, mix it well so that the lumps are not formed. And then cover and cook for around 5 to 6 minutes so that the flavor of all the spices will infuse with the saag completely. After 4 to 5 minutes, you can see here, the saag is ready. Serve this saag with makke ki roti or puri, paratha, naan, even simple chapati will taste delicious. If you have liked this recipe, do give a thumbs up, share it with your friends and subscribe for more such delicious recipes on Delicacies on the Plate. Don't forget to click on the bell button to get the further notifications of my upcoming videos.